What's good YouTube, man? It's your boy Yachty coming at y'all with another video. And before the video starts, I just want to thank you guys, man, for everything. We just hit big 1.4k, man. I appreciate every single last one of you guys that support me, bro. We've been going up drastically lately, and I just want to thank you guys for all the support that you guys have been showing me. But in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys the best inside center build in the game. You know what I'm saying? All of these things right here, it doesn't matter, but obviously you want to go center. Doesn't matter what hand, don't matter what jersey number, you could be your personal favorite. But let's go ahead and hit continue. The pie chart you guys want to choose is the all red pie chart. It's all the way at the bottom, so you scroll all the way at the bottom. It's the all red pie chart. Want to click that. The physical profile pie chart that you guys want to choose is the second one down. You know what I'm saying? You get a 59 speed, 52 acceleration, 60 vertical, and 95 strength. You want to click that one. All right, so with the attributes, you want to max out. We're gonna go from top to bottom. You're gonna max out everything in finishing. You know what I'm saying? Everything, standing dunk, driving dunk, everything. So that'll give you a total of 16 finishing badges. You don't want to touch anything in shooting, because like I said, it's an inside center build. You're not going to be shooting the ball. And, but for playmaking, you just want to max out pass accuracy. So when you throw the ball down the court, you won't throw it out of bounds. You know what I'm saying? Get the ball down court. You want to max out everything. And defensive rebounding, make sure you max out everything. Don't miss anything. So the badges you guys will get is 16 finishing, 1 shooting, 1 playmaking, and 30 defense and rebounding. The body type, the best body type for centers, period, is burly. You know what I'm saying? You take up more space on the court. And I've noticed a crazy difference in the screens. You know what I'm saying? The bigger your body is, the harder, like, it is for people to get around your screens. You set big bodies with, if you're burly. The height you guys want to go with, the default is 7 foot. But for this build, we're going to go 6'11". 6'11 is the overall best height for a center, no matter what you are. The best overall height is 6'11". Look how many pluses you get when you go down to 6'11". You get a freaking plus 5 speed, acceleration, a plus 7 in vertical. You get a plus 6 in steal, plus 9 in lateral quickness, plus 7 in perimeter defense. You know what I'm saying? You get a calm plus 2 in pass accuracy and plus 1 in ball handle. You know what I'm saying? You get a plus 3 in driving layup and a plus 5 in driving dunk. And with this build, you can guard. Trust me. If you get left on the island with a guard, I'm telling you, if you have a good defense, you can keep up with a guard. Because look at your lateral quickness. And these stats are your stats at 95. So when you hit 99, your stats will go up a plus 4. So you have a 70 something lateral quickness and almost like a 80 lateral, an 80 perimeter defense. You know what I'm saying? You can keep up with guards, bro. And you have like a 70 something speed at 99, so you're gonna be quick. You know what I'm saying? And the height, I keep messing up, but the way you want to go with is, I went 254. You could go 252 if you want to, but I just went 254 for the hell of it. Wingspan, you want to max that out, obviously, so you have long enough arms to get them blocks, steals, and rebounds. And the takeover, obviously, glass cleaning your inside center build. You want to have the rebound and takeover. I'm going to go ahead and hit complete. And we're going to go over the test build so I can show you guys the best badges for inside center. All right, I just finished loading. Put this at 99. We're going to start off with the defensive and rebounding badges. First and foremost, when I go with Hall of Fame brick wall. Second, box Hall of Fame, so you could keep your box out. You know what I'm saying? Make sure nobody breaks your box out. Next badge is a must, Hall of Fame rebound chaser, so you don't be getting snagged on. Hall of Fame rim protector, so you could get them blocks. You know what I'm saying? Chase down others Hall of Fame too. You want to know why? I'm gonna tell you guys why. This badge is probably one of the best defensive badges in the game. You know what I'm saying? You can jump. Say if somebody already beat you to the paint, they're already going over a layup. If you have a high enough vertical, your player will jump all the way from the free throw line and get a block animation. Most of the time, if you have Hall of Fame rim protector and chase down artist on, you will get a lot of chase down blocks. I'm telling you, this badge is probably the best, one of the best badges in the game. If you don't believe me, try it. I'm telling you, that badge is OP. And the next badge we're gonna go with is Hall of Fame Pogo Stick. You know what I'm saying? So if you're going against a center that likes to pump fake a lot, you could keep up with the pump fakes when you keep jumping. This badge allows you to jump a lot, like more than one time. And the next badge I'm gonna be showing you guys, this badge right here, Interceptor. You don't have to put a Hall of Fame. I prefer a gold. It's good enough on gold. You'll get a lot of passing lane steals. And you can go gold clamps just in case if you get left on the island with a guard. You know what I'm saying? You could have gold clamps on so you don't get baked. Or you can go with gold intimidator. You know what I'm saying? Gold intimidator helps a lot as well. But in my opinion, I like gold clamps because Chase Down Artist and Rim Protector makes up for intimidator for me. Alright, those are the defensive badges. For the playmaking badge, you can either go with Unpluggable or Breakstarter. I go with Breakstarter because I play wreck. With shooting, you don't have any shooting, so you can just put on anything. I just put on catch and shoot. And with these finishing badges, you want to put on Gold Lob City Finisher so you don't miss any lobs. You want to put on Gold Fenty Forward just in case if you have an open lane and somebody's in there, you could hit it with a hop step and get them out of your way. And with this badge, with Fenty Forward on, you want to have on Slithery Finisher. This badge helps you when you're like in contact with somebody. You could hit him with a hop step, and then when you hit him with the hop step, it completely moves the player out of the way so you can have an easy take. You want to throw on a Relentless Finisher, you know what I'm saying? So if you got contact in the paint, so center in the paint, finish the ball easier. You want to go with Gold Contact Finisher so you can get contact dunks and stuff. Those are the badges, you know what I'm saying? Those are the best badges in the game, you know what I'm saying? These are the best badges to use as a center. I would recommend put those badges on. Let me show you guys one more time. Contact Finisher, Relentless, Slithery, Fancy Footwork, Lob City, and you could put the last badge on anything. The bronze doesn't really show too much. Just put it on Drop Stepper for the hell of it. But yeah, that was the center build. That's my center build, and I personally feel like that is the best center build in the game. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. It's been your boy Yachty, and I'm out, man. Peace.